And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot comprehend it. There is a need for light in the midst of the prevailing darkness on the earth today that will shatter the power of darkness. And that light is the Word of the Living God. The vessel of the Living God, Bishop Abiola Idowu, brings you the light.
A new song coming to you. A new song.
Through the Word of God that will bring you to total fulfillment in life. No more sickness, disease, failure, guilt, condemnation, and affliction in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, welcome Bishop Abiola Idowu.
Praise the Lord. I'm so excited to be with you again tonight on Dominion Over Sickness and Disease. It is a program that God has designed to inoculate you against every virus, against every cancer, bacteria, whatever infection it may be. Now, you need to have an understanding of what God is saying concerning things, not what everybody is saying concerning it. Now, everyone I've discovered have opinion about things. And opinion and God's divine word are not the same thing. Now, when you agree with the opinion of the world, you will miss the counsel of God. There are things that people think or imagine that can be in line with the word of God. That one is acceptable. But when it's not in line with the word of God, no matter how real it looks like, never believe it, because it will put you in bondage. So tonight, I'm so excited that you are here with us. Not wherever you are watching from on any platform, welcome to the time that your life will change forever. But before we go into the word tonight, let's just have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. I give you all the praise for a glorious opportunity that we have to come boldly before the throne of grace and get into our inheritance and what God has designed for our destiny. We are so thankful. We are so grateful. We worship you. We bless your name. Receive all our praise in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking, Lord, as the word goes forth tonight, Lord, that you will heal, you will deliver, you will set free, you will break the shackles of darkness, you will destroy every grip of sickness and disease. Lord Jesus, you will grant unto your children, Lord, the peace and the joy that you have designed through our Lord Jesus. Thank you, because I know it's done. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome you again to this awesome time. And I want you to just take your pen and paper and let's go into the word. Because it takes understanding of the principles of the kingdom to enjoy living. God didn't just send you here to just come and experiment. Neither is he trying to get you into trouble before he bail you out. That is not his time. Now, Jesus spent most of his time here on earth to teach about the kingdom principles so that people can live as if they are in heaven already. It takes the understanding of the kingdom principle to make life meaningful and enjoyable. So you will discover that from the scripture, sickness and diseases are not part of God's plan. No, God didn't put it here to humble you, to teach you anything. It is against God's will. In fact, God hates sickness. He hates diseases just as he hates the devil that brought it here. So Jesus Christ came to establish the good life that you are designed to live. Now, if the coming of Jesus is not taking away sickness and diseases from our life, then redemption is incomplete. And the redemption that God has given to us is a complete plan to put us in a place of joy, peace, and make us to live a life of dominion over everything that God has created. Now, but there are underlying principles that you need to have so that you can rule where other people are complaining. Number one thing is that understand the fact that there is nothing created by God that is more powerful than man. There is nothing. Now, you can call it name. Now, you can say, well, it's the research of people. No, I'm talking about what everyone is saying concerning you. Now, I've discovered a lot of people that have watched so many movies, and it looks as if there are things that God created that is stronger than man. No. By the act of God's divine arrangement, man is in charge of running the planet. Now, let me show you something here. In Psalm 8, verse 6, he said, thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hand, that has put all things under his feet. So no virus, no bacteria is strong enough to kill you without your approval. Not even the devil can. He said, you made him to have dominion over the works of his hand. Now, if it is created by God, then it's under your, control. If it is created by God, then God has put you, or he has given you authority over them. Now, when things come, people begin to live in fear and in subjection of it, because the enemy is putting fear in your heart about your position. Now, when you know your position, then I'm telling you, your location will change. Now, let me tell you number two. Now, God decided to put man here on earth to dominate everything he created. Remember, there is nothing bigger than you. God put you here to dominate everything he created. You have authority to shut anything down in the name of Jesus. Bible says in Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, he said, and God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. That is it. So you will discover from the scripture that there is nothing that is here that's supposed to terrify you. He said, the heaven of heaven is the Lord, the earth has he given to the children of men. Now, he put you here. That is the design. Now, people can come and tell you stories about their discovery. I'm talking about the one that set everything in there. Now, you will discover that it was the discovery of Adam and Eve that took them out of the garden. Now, stop discovering what God has not shown you. Now, the truth is here in the word of the living God, that God said that cancer cannot kill you, because the Bible says he gave you dominion over it. Number three is, now it is man's choice or choices that makes him to submit himself to the things that God put under him. Now, there is nothing, there is nowhere in the scripture that the Bible says things that were created will destroy and kill you. No, it is a choice. Now, you can decide to live, God will agree with you. You can decide to die, God will agree with you. If you can decide to be sick, God will agree to. But let me tell you this, that is not his design. That is not his plan. I saw in the scripture, Bible says in Deuteronomy chapter number 30 and verse 19. Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 19. He said, I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life, that both thou and thy seed may live. So you will see that one. He said, I have set before you life and death. He said, choose what you want. Now, we have seen a lot of people choosing death and putting the blame on God. So you can't get yourself under the jurisdiction of the devil when the creator himself has put you above it. Now, if you put yourself under it by just living in fear of it, now you have made a choice. And don't ever say God put you there. Don't ever say that it is the devil. No, it's your agreement. Now, let me tell you this. The devil can invade your kidney. He can invade your liver. He can invade your blood. He can invade your life without you agreeing with him. How many of us have discovered that even as powerful as our Father in heaven is, God will not do something in your life until you believe it. You believe him for what he said. Now, how dare you think the devil can just break into your life without your approval? You have to believe in his fear. You have to believe in his suggestions. If you don't believe in his suggestions, then what God has said concerning you will begin to rule. Now, number four, God's divine strategy is man to exercise faith in the verdict of his creator, in order to take his place on the earth. That is the design of God. You have to have faith in what God says. It's the divine strategy of God to put you in charge. Everything that pertains to life and godliness have been given to you, but it cannot get into your life until you begin to exercise faith in the spoken word of God. Bible says in Mark chapter 9 and verse number 23, Bible says, Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, All things are possible to him that believeth. That puts you in the class of divinity. That all things are possible to God and all things are possible to you because you believe. Now, and God is not asking you to scratch your brain so that you can believe something. No, what to believe is already put there. And that is why he gave you this scripture. Each time you take the word of God by the, as it is spoken, as it's written, now God steps in into your life to perform his word. Now you don't need to impress God for God to work wonders in your life. All you need to do is to believe what he said. When you believe what he said, God is more than enough to make that word a reality in your life. So we saw that the dominion has been given to you, the authority has been given to you, but you have to exercise your faith. So your faith in the spoken word changes everything. And number five, man must use the same power that put him here to rule this earth. Man must use the same power that put him here to rule the earth. So what power put you here? The power of the spoken word. Remember, God spoke into existence the sun and the moon. God spoke into existence the constellations. God spoke into existence everything that we see here. And he gave the authority to man to speak like himself. So it is by the declaration of the word of God that you take dominion over everything that is on the earth. No sickness. Don't wait for sickness to come before you begin to declare what God said concerning your health, what God said concerning your longevity. You begin to declare that 120 is my days, and I will use it in sound head, in sound mind. Nothing is permitted to stop me. My blood, my bones are intact. In the mighty name of God, I refuse anything that causes sickness and diseases in my body. Now, see this one in Mark Gospel, chapter 11, verse 23 and 24. Mark 11, 23 and 24. Bible says, "For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them." That is the word of the living God. God said that is the only way you will begin to live. You see, because God, that is the way God operates here. Now, remember, when Jesus Christ spoke to that tree, now it withered from the root by the spoken word. So it means if you are going to be in charge and rule sickness and disease, you have to start speaking. Because you are a product of the word of the Lord. Manifest. Bible says God breathed the breath of life into man, and man became a speaking spirit or a living soul. So you start speaking against what you are feeling. You start speaking what the enemy is speaking into your ears or into your heart. And before you know it, you will wear him out. Now, tonight, I want you to begin to take steps based upon what you have heard. And begin to rule all these things that want to take over your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are going to start from here. We are going to agree. We are going to pray. Whatsoever is invading your body, arthritis, cancer, unusual growth, fever, migraine, whatever it is, we are going to wear them out now in the mighty name of Jesus. I will pray. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we agree together tonight by the authority that is in the name of Jesus, because we have dominion over sickness and disease according to the word of the living God. Therefore, I take authority over every inflammation. I take authority over every sickness, every disease, every cancer cells, every fever. Hear the word of the living God. I bind you and I cast you out of those bodies in the mighty name of Jesus. Every area the devil is holding you bound, I break the force and the power of the enemy. I come against every counsel of the wicked one. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I decree by the authority that is in the name of Jesus Christ, receive your healing, receive your sound head, receive your breakthrough. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, everything that is contrary to the will and the purpose of God in your body, I cast them out right now. In the name of Jesus, Be healed. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Do you just know what happened right now? Your healing is established. I want you to begin to say the same thing that God is saying, and you begin to see a greater manifestation. But listen, if you are listening to my voice today, one thing that God wants you to know is that He loves you so much. He didn't want you to go through life toiling, struggling. He wants His life, His glory to shine upon you. He wants everybody to see you and just say, that's a child of God. But until you agree with Him based upon His word, and you give your life to Him, and you allow Him to come into your heart, there is nothing He can do. Now, can't you just think about this with me today and allow Jesus Christ to come in? Let Him be the Lord of your life. Let Him take charge of everything, and you will live a brand new life. Just say this simple prayer with me, and a new beginning will start. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you thanks for the great opportunity that you have given to me to come boldly before your presence today. Father, Lord Jesus, I give my life to you. Take over my life. From today, fill me with your Holy Spirit. Let me live my life through your name and through your glory. Thank you for saving me in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Do you know what just happened right now? You are now a child of the living God. Your name is already written in the Lamb Book of Life. Now begin to fellowship with the children of God so that the new life that you have right now will begin to show to the world to see in the mighty name of Jesus. And you have every opportunity to join us again tomorrow night at 7171 Arlington Expressway for a wonderful time as we fellowship with the Word of God. And your life will never remain the same again. And on Sunday, 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. respectively, you have an opportunity to have an encounter with the God of heaven and the earth, and your life will never remain the same again. We encourage you to send your testimony to us at media@crepa.org. media@crepa.org. And I'm telling you, we will rejoice with you for the things that the Lord is doing in your life. Till I see you again next week, stay blessed. And remember, Jesus is alive.